Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study suicide enzyme inhibition. So this suicide enzyme inhibition is irreversible inhibition. Here the inhibitor molecules, or you can say the modified substrates, they are actually look similar to substrate. They are substrate analogs. Their structure is almost similar to the substrate, just like competitive enzyme inhibition. And they bind to active site as that of competitive enzyme inhibition. But here, unlike competitive enzyme inhibition, in suicide enzyme inhibition, the substrate analog or inhibitor molecule bind to active site of an enzyme and produce some products, usually the abnormal products, or sometimes if it is in a pathway, it produces normal products for next 2 to 3 reactions of that particular pathway, and then produce an abnormal product. And this abnormal product binds to the enzyme and make it inactive. This abnormal product binds to enzyme covalently, bind to enzyme tightly and make it inactive, or it may modify active site of that particular enzyme so that it cannot catalyze the specific enzymatic reaction. So this is actually just a brief introduction of suicide enzyme inhibition. This suicide enzyme inhibition is also called mechanism-based inactivation because the substrate analog itself is not going to inhibit. When the reaction takes place, the product formed will bind to enzyme active site and make this particular enzyme inactive. Let me explain this concept. First, we will see normal enzymatic reaction. So when enzyme combines with its natural substrate, it will produce enzyme substrate complex. And later on, it will give enzyme unchanged and the product. This is the usual mechanism of enzyme catalyzed reaction. With the suicide inhibition, here we have an enzyme and we have an inhibitor in the form of substrate analog or modified substrate. Now here it binds to active site of an enzyme. We can call it as enzyme inhibitor complex because later on it will produce an actual inhibitor. Now this reaction proceeds and give the enzyme, and so you can see here the enzyme is unchanged, same enzyme, and an abnormal product. Because of this substrate analog binding to the active site, there is going to be an abnormal product formation. Now this abnormal product going to bind to the active site of an enzyme, that particular enzyme, and makes that enzyme inactive. Now you can see here, you can appreciate here, the conformation of the enzyme is altered. Maybe its active site is modified. And this abnormal product binds to this enzyme covalently so that it commits suicide here. In other words, this enzyme is inactivated. So that is why it is called mechanism-based inactivation. So unlike all other inhibition, this inhibition, there is a product formed. Maybe if it is a particular pathway, there may be a subsequent 1 or 2 normal reaction. Then later on an abnormal product is formed. This abnormal product binds to that enzyme and make it inactive, or it induces conformational change in the enzyme so that it no longer catalyzes the specific reaction. This is actually mechanism of suicide enzyme inhibition. We will see the clinical significance of suicide enzyme inhibitors. There are many drugs useful for treating many diseases or disorders. You can see the aspirin. It is an analgesic, it is a painkiller. Not only it is an analgesic, it also decreases fever, antipyretic and anti-inflammatory. This aspirin is a suicide inhibitor. It going to bind to active site of cyclooxygenase and produce a product that will bind to cyclooxygenase and make cyclooxygenase inactive. Similarly, in alcoholic de-addiction or chronic alcoholic patient, if you give disulfiram, it is a drug which bind to acetaldehyde dehydrogenase and make this enzyme inactive so that there is accumulation of acetaldehyde in the liver and it produce nausea, vomiting and alcohol avoidance in that chronic alcoholic patient. Similarly, an antibiotic which usually kills the bacteria, that is penicillin, which actually inhibit a bacterial transpeptidase. This particular enzyme is very much essential for bacterial cell wall synthesis. Now this penicillin bind to this bacterial transpeptidase and makes this enzyme inactive so that bacteria cannot survive without cell wall. It can be used as antibacterial or antibiotic. Similarly, to treat depression and Parkinson's disease, we can use deprenyl, which is again a suicide inhibitor for the enzyme monoamine oxidase. This deprenyl can be used to treat depression and Parkinson's disease. 5-fluorouracil, which is an anti-cancer drug to treat cancer, which actually inhibits thymidylate synthase, which is an important or essential enzyme for biosynthesis like thymine or uracil. So if this enzyme is inhibited, there is no cell division, so that we can arrest excessive cell division in cancerous tissues. So these are the few examples for suicide inhibitors. Suicide enzyme inhibition is irreversible enzyme inhibition where the substrate analog bind to active site of an enzyme and carry out reaction and produce abnormal product, and this abnormal product going to bind to that active site of an enzyme, and this binding is covalently binding or tight binding, so that enzyme becomes inactive. Thanks for watching.